over to BoardGamePrices.com to find the best price for Console of 4 and thousands of other games. Hello, my friends, it's the Game Boy Geek here, and today we're going to be trying to influence all different council members. We're going to be doing that by giving them permits and trying to build, sometimes, emporiums out by the countryside in some editions and have some merchants selling things in other editions. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Council of Four. A while ago, a few years ago, Council 4 came out by Cranio Creations out in Europe, did not have a wide distribution in North America, but I had played it back then, and I reviewed it a long time ago, and I highly, highly recommend and love Council 4. It is one of the best sort of 60-minute midweight Euros, I think, in my entire collection. But recently, CMON has released this in North America, and they've done a lot of changes to the game. So I'm just going to do first edition versus second edition, show you all the art, all the components, all the changes of both function and balance that has been made, and tell you what I thought about all these. So let me show you all this, and I'll see you on the other side for my final thoughts. First, we'll take a look at the boxes. We got the original edition and the second edition. Now, two things here, art and box size. Now, art's very subjective. I actually prefer the older art better. It actually makes me feel more like an older console, where this looks more like a fantasy world, which I think a lot of people will like better, but I personally like the art style on this better. However, I do like the box size of this one better. It's that more standard size Ticket to Ride size box that fits well on shelves. This one's a little bit smaller. Some people might like that better because it's smaller, but I like the standard box sizes better. Now here we have the first edition board set up. You can see what the artwork looks like, some of the components. We'll be going into the details of these in just a moment. One of the big differences between this game and one that caused a little bit of controversy is this one had a modular board setup, where it had three different independent sections here, and they could actually be flipped over. Like this blue archon is here, but when you flip it over, it kind of becomes a D and moves over here, where this one, the blue is the M, but then if you flipped it over, it then became an L. And this kind of changed, made these a lot closer sometimes, which is big because, getting both blues, can get you, some good bonuses and things like that. And especially because you only need to get two blues to get this, and then you could get the 25. So that could be a 30-point swing. And sometimes these were a little bit too close, I think some people had thought, and so did CMON thought, that it wasn't quite as balanced sometimes. But it did give you the flexibility to kind of change these things around like this, and gave you some more flexibility. So it gave you the appearance of a lot more replayability, but it could have caused some possible balance issues that some people had complained about. Whereas with the new edition, there's actually two sides of the boards. They're not modulars. Basically, you have two different sides. One of the sides is almost identical to one of the setups in the original, and the other side is actually very closely identical to one of the other possible setups in the other ones. Like this one looks like they're close, as we just talked about, but it's actually kind of far away if you think about it. So I think CMON did a good job of trying to give you replayability without giving you any of the possible problems that were with the balance of the first game. I actually prefer the new board here, both in color and the way it looks. Like these tend to pop up, the colors really come up strong, or these tend to look very bland and just not as, they don't really pop quite as well. Now in the first edition, the nobility track was on the bottom of the board. This one has a separate board. This is actually just half of it, it's folded. It goes up and down, it's next to the board, and they had to do that because the board is so much larger in the new edition. But this one goes this way and this one goes this way. And there's a couple of differences. The first two bonuses actually come a little bit earlier, a couple spaces earlier to help you get your engine going. So I welcome that change in this one, so I actually like this better. I actually like the art better of kind of going through these different columns of this big council. So I like the way that they incorporated this artwork-wise into the board, but I like having this a little bit earlier. This one also is used to track the different bonuses that we showed you on the other one, and the money on a separate track here. That part's pretty much similar, but again, earlier bonuses, but I kind of like this artwork a little bit better. Okay, let's talk about probably one of the biggest things, the council members. This is sort of the elephant in the room here. The original edition was really cool that they had wooden bits and they went into these balconies. And as you replaced the one, you would push this down and somebody would fall off. And from a tactile feel thing, this was so fun to do, to push them off, watch them fall over. And we really loved it. It really made the game memorable. However, I will say that it did kind of become a pain in the butt sometimes, where these would often dislodge loose and it was hard to get them to sit right. And sometimes it was a little bit finicky. They'd fall apart a little bit like that. Even so much so that we had a friend of ours kind of like make some 3D printed ones that were much better. But we really loved that aspect of the game. Now in the second edition, in usual CMON faction, they had to create some awesome miniatures, and they did that for each of the console members. And so now when you want to replace one, you simply just push these down. This one gets removed. They don't fall off of a balcony. Man, I really wish they could have figured out a way to have put these on something to fall off. It really would have done the best of both worlds, but I guess you got to give and take on something with the prices of the game. And now here's some shots of some of the same colors that were used with the first edition console members and CMON's second edition. Obviously no comparison. Having the minis is really cool. And now all the colors were the same. So you'll see some yellows and grays and greens that we didn't obviously put the wooden pieces up next to it because there's different colors. But as you can see, the console members are much more cool looking in the new edition. Now in the first edition, on the left was the king that would move around the different spots on the board. And on the right, you have this awesome miniature that is a queen. Obviously much better on the new edition. For me, no comparison here with player aids and more components. This is the generic player aid everyone got in the original with your scoring markers and your emporiums that you would put out. Well, here everyone has their own player aid with their own color, with their own character, with their own character mini. I'll show you in just a moment more detail, and their merchants that they would put out instead of emporiums. And it just looks so much more beautiful. And here it is in much more detail, and that big figure is literally just used to show everybody what color you are. Even though they can look at your player aid, it wasn't really necessary, but again, another cool factor. And so here's a look at all the minis that are used in the game for each player's color and the corresponding player aids with the art for this new edition. Now here we're looking at the different assistants in the two different editions, the original and the second edition. I always disliked the ones in the first edition that they always looked like they were like cloak and dagger going, getting ready to kill somebody, which this game is not about. These ones are assistants here. I think they're much more colorful. They're much nicer to look at, values of one and values of three. I definitely like the new ones better. Now the markers that are used for scoring and going up the nobility tracks and stuff, again, was just chits in the first one, but they were a nice looking artwork with you know, these little markers. So definitely a lot nicer on the new edition here. Now here's the different permit tiles from first edition and the new second edition. I never had a problem with the first edition. I thought it was fine, but when I look at it next to the second edition, the artwork is larger and it's more colorful and it really does pop better. So I do like the second edition better here. Now when you flip the tiles over, you know, these ones tend to be a little bit harder to read because they were trying to make it look like that old script, like the J is kind of hard to read, where it's much more clear here. Now obviously the tiles do different things, the permits, just because the boards are different. And so it looks like that CMON did kind of redevelop what these tiles do, but I still like the look of these better, they're cleaner. Now here are the different cards that you use to influence the council members. Here's the first edition. I always loved sort of that sealed envelope. This is the back side, and then the front side had, you know, this is a joker, it can be used for anyone, and these are the specific colors. I always loved that. This one obviously takes in account the new, you know, the different council members themselves, which fits well here, and this is what the joker looks like. Now both of them have the same distribution, 12 of each color, 13 wilds. I actually still really prefer this classy look here, because I don't really care too much about the you know, the sort of the fantasy looking council members, but I mean, it does fit the game well. Now here are the bonus tokens, first edition, second edition. The backside, it's not too important. These were just ugly and red. This one has a nice little piece of artwork there, but those are only used at the beginning of the game before you flip them over. Not a big deal, but again, more attention to detail. Now all of these are actually pretty much exactly the same except for one of them. This one would have gotten you a card, and this one gets you a card, 3 points. So this one actually gets you, lets you get a little bit more points with that. So one little balance there. And the first edition just has a regular insert like that. You just put all the components in bags like that, and the boards all fit in just like this. And with the new edition, you've got the minis on the bottom with a separate insert to hold everything else. This little piece here goes in and actually shows you how the miniatures go, both on the top and the bottom, because on top of that comes the council member minis just like this. Very nice insert like that. And then of course, just the board and the smaller board goes on just like that. All right, well, there you have it. Now I'm just gonna summarize pretty much all the things I talked through, and I'm gonna talk through it pretty quickly because this is just a summary of everything you just watched. Box size. Second edition, I liked better because it's sort of a standard size. Art, I actually like the first edition better, sort of that classic. They actually looked like council members, not some crazy weird fantasy people. The board, the look and functionality, absolutely loved the second edition better. Even though there's actually less flexibility, depending on what people say, you know, the first one had more quote unquote replayability or variability, but some of it I don't think was as balanced. I think CMON did a good job of balancing it, giving you two different sections, but making the board really look good and pop well. The nobility track, I'm calling this one a tie. I liked the second edition balance better, where you get points and things a little bit faster on the first two bonuses, but I liked the art of the first edition better, actually, going under those little columns made it look like you were going to a council. The council members and the king and queen, no doubt, hands down, second edition by far. Yes, I miss the balconies. Yes, I would love to have those big new minis of the council members sit on some type of big balcony and push them off. Maybe they'll come up with some type of promo or extra little mini expansion that you can buy where you can push them off these big, you know, balconies. That would be even cooler. That'd be the best of both worlds. But even without the balconies, it's just such a great production step up, second edition for those. And again, the queen to a little pawn, it's no-brainer there. The player aids, second edition, much better. Everyone has their own. Sure, all it does is show your color and your art, but it's a good change, and you have that nice little character to put on there. Definitely second edition's better. The emporiums were in the first edition, those little houses, those wood houses, and now you have those cool looking minis, the merchants. The scoring markers were just discs before, but now they're these cool little, you know, minis. Second edition, much better. Assistants, the little assistants you spend. The first ones looked kind of creepy and weird. This next one looked kind of fun and they pop. I like those. The permit tiles, pretty close, but I liked the artwork on the second edition better. It was bigger and the other side popped and it was more legible from the letters perspective, clearer to read. The cards. Those influence cards, I actually like the first edition better. I like just the seal. It just looked classy. The new ones, sure, they show the new council members, but I'm not really into those fantasy looking council members, so I didn't like that as much. So first edition won on that one for me. Bonus tokens, I like the second edition better. They have a nicer side while you're shuffling them, and they've, you know, they balance a little bit more to give you a little bit more points on some of those, makes it a little bit more exciting. So in summary, the first edition, I like the balconies, the box art, and the influence cards. Everything else, I liked second edition better. So if you have not got either of these editions, hopefully now you can see, because a lot of this is subjective, but I've shown you those so that you can make your own decision. For me, this was a clobbering, actually. Second edition, much better for me. That's the one I'll be keeping. I'll be getting rid of my first edition. I just wish, hey, CMON, if you're listening, let's make some balconies for the second edition to make everybody happy. This has been the Game Boy Geek, helping you find and enjoy the next board game you'll love. Don't forget to head on over to BoardGamePrices.com to find the best price for a console of four and thousands of other games.